This whole COVID-19 has caused a lot of entertainment venues and businesses to shut down in order to contain the virus. This means that a lot of gigging musicians are out of job now, and live streaming is becoming an alternative option to provide entertainment to the people around you. And I get it, you can just perform to your phone on Facebook and Instagram live every night and people will still tune into it. But what about those of us who want our audio to sound good and our video to look good for our audience at home to enjoy a quality broadcast? Anyway, my name is Cheng and I am a gigging musician here in Singapore. Welcome to my channel. Check out some of the videos that I've done, and if you like those kind of videos, you can consider subscribing to me. Today, I'm going to show you how I set up my Facebook live stream. I will be going through some of the gears that I used, and if you don't have these gears, you can consider investing in them. Here are the things that you need. Number one, you need an audio interface or an audio mixer. You know, those kind that you use at the bars, at the places that you perform at. Something like this. This is the Yamaha MG12XU mixer that I use for some of my gigs. It has onboard effects as well. Also, make sure that your mixer has a USB connection so that you can connect a USB cable from your mixer to your computer. Number two, you need all the necessary cables that connect your instruments and your microphones into the mix board. Number three, you need a way to monitor the sound of your mix through your mixer board. So you need to have headphones that you can actually plug this into the phone output of your mixer board. In my case, I use the stereo left-right channel and go into the headphone amp so that my phone output is actually free for me to connect it to my phone and use it for IG live streaming. I made a video last year, so go and check it out. Number four, you need a laptop or computer. Number five, you need to install this program called OBS on your computers. It is free to download, so you can go ahead and download them. Number six, you need a webcam, or you can use a camera if you want. For webcam-wise, it's very straightforward. You just connect your webcam to your computer and it should work naturally. But for those of you who wants to use the DSLR and have your live stream have the DSLR effect, right? You need something called the Cam Link. What Cam Link does is that it takes the HDMI output of your camera and converts it into a USB so that OBS can read it. I mean, this is quite overkill, but if you want to have the DSLR effect, right, this is one of the options that you can consider. Number seven, internet speed. Now, it actually depends on how high of a quality you want your live stream to be, but of course, the higher quality, the faster your internet need to be. But generally, for videos not to be cut off during live stream, you need a download speed of like 3 Mbps, and you have to have an upload speed of 5 Mbps. You can type speed test into your Google search and go and test your speed. Of course, the more the better lah. The last thing you need is completely optional. It is the video lighting. I use this softbox thingy so that all my videos are bright enough and you can see my pretty face. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. First thing first, get your audio mixed nicely on the mixer board. I like to use the PFL button to make sure that all my audio signals are healthy and clean before I mix them. This also makes sure they are loud enough before it distorts or clipped. Afterwards, send it to your main mix and then mix it through your headphones. Next thing, make sure you EQ it properly. From the way I see it, when sometimes I go on people's live stream, I realize that their microphones are a bit muffled, or sometimes they are like, in general, there's a very, very low humming sound. So it might not be as well as you imagined. In my opinion, you don't really need the low frequencies of the microphone for your voice unless you're like a beatboxer. So try to EQ everything nicely, make sure the mix is perfect so that your audience can have an enjoyable time. The better the mix, the longer people will stay, right? Thirdly, after the mix is done, make sure you connect your mixer board to your computer via the USB port. Your computer should detect the mixer automatically. If not, just go online and download the driver for it. Number four, download OBS. Go to OBS website and download for your respective OS. After you install OBS, go ahead and create a scene. Scene is where you do your entire live stream or what the audience will see. Here you can put your audio, your video, and everything else that you want to put in. So we're gonna add our camera in first. You can go ahead and adjust the settings if you want to. The audio should be detected normally already. If not, just go ahead and add an audio input capture here. Make sure you select the right interface, okay? Afterwards, it comes the mixing part. This is the window where you can mix all your audio signals together. If you have done your mixing correctly on your mixer board, you shouldn't have to worry about anything. Just make sure that your audio level stays about -20 to -15 dB. You'll be fine. The fifth step, after you set everything up, go to your Facebook and create a live session. Please create a private session first before you do any broadcast to test out all your mixes. You can access this from your Facebook homepage. Go and click the Facebook Live button, and you need to find the stream key for this to work. How you're gonna do this is by starting Facebook Live, find the Use Stream Key tab and click on it. Once you found the stream key, go ahead and copy it and go back to OBS. In OBS, go to the settings on the bottom right hand corner, press stream, choose Facebook Live and paste the stream key and click OK at the bottom. Once you're done, press start streaming. Go back to your Facebook Live and click go live. Before that, make sure that this is only viewable by yourself. Now this is the part where you start performing and singing to it as a sound check. Once your Facebook actually goes live, you can actually use your phone to connect into your own Facebook and test out the audio. How you test the audio is by simply playing your instruments first, go to your phone and listen to the output. Make sure it's loud enough so that people can actually hear from wherever they are. Most of the time, people use phone to go into Facebook Live, so make sure that the audio is loud enough for everybody to hear on their phones. The reason why I call you to do your own private stream, your own sound checks first, is because you don't want to receive messages like, "It's too soft, cannot hear, I can't hear your keyboard, I can't hear everything else." So please save yourself first by testing it out. Once everything is done, once you're comfortable with the mix, go ahead and restart the stream and go live this time around. Make sure to invite everybody to a live stream and enjoy the live stream. Some pointers to note: whenever you go Facebook Live, the comments are actually 10 to 15 seconds behind, so your replies are generally slower. If you really want faster and better engagement, try Twitch. The last thing to do is to enjoy the live stream, making sure that everybody is having a nice time, encouraging people to stay home, encourage them to stay safe, and of course, once this is over, you can encourage them to come out and support you once again. So that's it from me, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hit the like button if you enjoy it and subscribe to me so that you won't miss out any videos from me next time. If you guys have any question at all, leave it in the comment below. Enjoy your live stream and I'll see you for the next video. Bye bye. Something poking me in my armpit. Your stream or the entire setup. Thanks. Thanks, Thor. So irritating. Also, make sure that your interface or your mixer has a USB connection that allows you to connect from your mixer to your interface. Oh, shit. Computer.